on Earth, the radio waves help us communicate with one another. But in deep space, they might be able to help us find the universe's missing matter. Hey guys, Amy with you on DNews today. There are a lot of pretty insane things happening in space all the time, but perhaps none are so mysterious as fast radio bursts. FRBs are immensely powerful events that can put out as much energy as our sun can in 10,000 years, but they show up randomly and last just milliseconds, making them really hard to measure or follow up on. Scientists have only positively identified 16 FRBs in history. And further complicating our attempts to understand them, FRBs are rarely, if ever, observed in real time. For the most part, they're discovered months or even years after they occur by astronomers combing through archived data. But trust eager scientists to devise a way to learn about these mysterious events. In an attempt to catch an FRB before it's gone, a team of international astronomers led by E.F. Keene set up an early warning system. If one telescope receives a signal consistent with an FRB, it alerts other scientists at other participating observatories so they can quickly slew their dishes to look in the right area of the sky that the signal was first heard. And it worked. On April 18th of 2015, the 64-meter Parkes radio telescope in Australia detected an FRB flash appropriately named FRB-150418. The early warning system notified the collaborating astronomers who got a second telescope in Australia and a third in Hawaii looking in the right part of the sky. Visible light imaging found the FRB came from an elliptical galaxy. Spectral analysis helped them determine that that galaxy was 6 billion light years away. That's an insane halfway across the visible universe. So here's where it gets interesting. Based on the energy output of FRBs, astronomers assumed they were produced when stars formed. But elliptical galaxies are old and don't have a lot of active star formation, and the event lasted longer than typical stellar formation does. So they concluded that this FRB couldn't be the result of the birth of a star. Instead, it's more likely that the burst was caused by a pair of coalescing neutron stars, the superdense remains of exploded stars merging together to form a black hole. This is an incredibly powerful and violent event that releases a lot of energy in a short burst that would last milliseconds, which is consistent with an FRB. But the story gets even better and has to do with finding missing matter in the universe. The total mass-energy makeup of the universe can be roughly divided into three components. Dark energy makes up about 70%, dark matter about 25%, and normal matter the remaining 5%. The problem is that we can only see half the normal matter. The rest is hard to detect gas between galaxies. But this FRB helped us find that missing matter. Radio waves traveling through the universe are dispersed as they pass through all the gas and dust distributed through space, and dispersion depends on what the radio waves are passing through. So measuring the way radio waves from this FRB were altered as they traveled through space and knowing how far they traveled, astronomers can determine the universe's makeup, including that missing matter. Scientists observed the radio waves produced from the FRB passed through something that changed them in a way that was measurable, and that something turned out to be the missing matter. Super neat, eh? Well, some astronomers don't think so. A paper has come out since this initial study saying that Keene's team may have jumped the gun on their FRB conclusion. The rebuttal paper from PKG Williams and E. Berger looks at the lingering radio luminosity of the host galaxy and concludes the signal is consistent with an active galactic nucleus, not an FRB. Basically, that would mean that the location and distance of the observed event couldn't be used to measure the composition of the universe. So that means we kind of have to come to everyone's favorite conclusion. More research is needed. But either way, how exactly did astronomers find these fast radio bursts in the first place? Lacey has some more on these cosmic phenomena in this video right here.
We now know with relative certainty that the bursts are coming from deep in space and probably outside of our galaxy. They think it's coming from outside the Milky Way because all of the initial bursts were more than 40 degrees from the galactic plane, making the likelihood of them coming from inside our galaxy pretty low.
So what do you guys think? Is this a fast radio burst, an active galactic nucleus, or aliens? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe so you never miss an episode of DNews.